Hello everybody, welcome back to The Legend of Zelda, The WindWaker HD. My name is Spencer and this is part 16. Wow, I can't believe we're on 16. So in the last episode we did some things on Dragon Roost Island as well as some more collectible stuff. And this one will also be collectible. So what we're going to do first is head south and explore some islands on the way around. My general goal with this episode is to have all of the islands in the middle of the map explored, so we'll try and accomplish that. And this will actually be our first one. This is Fire Island, I believe. So let's talk to the fish. Right, there's Fire Mountain. Not much we can do here yet. Not anything we can really do here yet, honestly. Basically what we would need to do is get the ability to shoot ice arrows, which will come here. So let's take care of this one really quick. I know these aren't the most exciting things to show, but it's all part of it, honestly. Oh shoot. Destroyed. Alright, keep climbing. You can do it. Let's switch the bombs to that one just because I know it's easier that way. Making our way up the ladder with I don't know that sound. Alright, so that one is easier for sure. Tiger that. And this one. How'd that bomb not explode those jars? Wasn't it right there? I don't know. Oh well. Oh my gosh, Spence, you're failing. Alright, so we got a golden feather. That's actually one of the more useful ones that we need right there for all those collection ones, but yes, that's good that we got that. And a yellow ruby. Because, you know, why not? Okay, so that kind of finishes that little thing. Let's keep heading south. And this one, oh, you know what? I want to get in one of these fights. So whenever you guys see a flock of seagulls like this, it usually means this happens. We will take this out. We're going to fight a big octo. You guys are sweet. The boomerang is necessary for these fights. If you get into one of these fights without a boomerang, you will just get eaten. That sucks. This is one of the easier ones. Got less eyes, there are more that have like 15 or 16 eyes, which just gets pretty hectic. You can get pretty close to the center before you actually kill him. It's kind of stressful. And you know you're doing damage to him, or like, you know you're done with like a certain eye when it turns blue. Right now they're all yellow. This should do it for a lot of them. Yeah, I'd say we got two or three. And there's four left, or five left still. Alright, so that's blue. I guess we have to hit this one more time. Quick. Alright, there we go. That was actually really close. Closer than I care to admit. But we'll go ahead and see what we get from these. Alright. So we, like I've kind of showed in a few episodes ago, you want to just kind of line up the crane and then guess. I'm guessing it's right here. Because it does disappear. Alright, and these usually give really good items too. Usually heart containers. Or pieces of heart, not heart containers. Or an orange ruby. That works too. We need those. So let's keep heading south. For real this time, for real. I actually want to head to that fairy island too, just because I feel like we could access that one as well. And the island that we'll need to explore as well is right there. So we'll go to that one first. Depending on whether or not I want to deal with those, yeah, I'll just save those platforms for another time. It's one of the more annoying ones too, because you have to climb up that spar one and then Deku Leaf fly over to that one. So I don't want to deal with that right now. We'll come back and do it. And can we deal with this? No, we cannot. We actually need an item that we don't have yet. So we'll go ahead and explore the island though. Where is the fish? Come on. Where you at, buddy? If you guys see the fish, let me know. I'll leave it in the comments where the fish is. There he is. Okay. Thanks for your help, guys. Really appreciate it. Alright. Hello, small fry. Blah, blah, blah. I'm gonna update your sea chart and all that. Alright, so that's Thorned Fairy Island. Again, not too much we can do there. Golden Feathers, Dragon Roost Island. Yeah, he's giving us that quest, basically. So, on our next one, we'll go ahead and we'll explore this area really quick, and then we'll head back to that little island right there. I'm gonna keep an eye out for the fish this time. This is something that we can actually do now, so we'll explore this island, do the event on it really quick, and then go explore the other island. Like I said, these videos don't really have any form right now just because it's all collection things, and I'm just trying to get as much materials as possible, just at the start at least, before we enter the next dungeon. Bird's Peak Rock. Okay, so this one's kind of tricky. In the sped up section I did with Beetle's shop and everything, when we bought a few items, I bought 2 Hoi pairs. Those will come into play here. So let's head back here. And, okay, so basically what the concept is there's this iron gate here and we need to open it. A lot of people will just see this and think, oh, we'll just have to do that. But that is indeed a false truth. So what we actually have to do is equip a Hoi pair. We have 2 of them. Hopefully we'll need only 2. I don't know if there's a beetle shop around here, but so we'll place that, and then in each one of these nests is a gate. Alright, we'll have to come back for that. It's kind of annoying. And if one of these vultures hits you, it will, oh my gosh. Monsters. Yeah, this gets a little hairy just with all the... Oh my gosh, what are we doing wrong? I don't get it! Alright, so we hit that one. I guess you have to hit them like kind of underneath. Sorry if you guys can hear me tapping the A button here. Oh my gosh. Alright, so we hit that one. I'm gonna try and go for this one again as well as that lower one. Oh my gosh, I can't even see my freaking bird. Alright, so we hit that one. So we need the high one in the middle, this one, and the low one. So what I'll do is I'll hit this one, I'll loop back around and gain some altitude, and then we'll dive bomb for the last one. Alright, so we'll just try. We're definitely not going to catch it on this thing. That's as low as you can dive at a time, so we'll gain a little bit of distance away, and then try and get it like this. Yeah, okay, that did it. That is a little stressful, but we're good. So, thank you, bird, for sacrificing yourself. It was all not in vain. Okay, this is something that we can't actually, I thought this would lead to a different area. Let me see. Designs that reflect wind are drawn here. So, what we have to do is play the Wind's Requiem, and I guess get an item that, I'm not sure what's gonna happen here, honestly. This is part of the Triforce thing at the end of the game, so I'm not sure what's gonna come out of this chest. Just because we're so early. I've never, like, encountered this early. Okay, so we got a Triforce chart. It's pretty funny. There's either five or three of those, because there's eight fragments that we need to get. And I know three are hidden or five are hidden, so. Alright, so that completes that island. We'll actually not need to come back here now, so that island is completely done, which is nice. And the next area we'll head to is actually over here. Sorry for that camera angle, guys. It'll be this one here. And while we're sailing, might as well equip this. Just checking some items and seeing where we're at. We have 28 Joy pendants, so we need 12 more before we can talk to Miss Joy. Isn't Miss Joy the Pokemon character? Like, I feel it. Nurse Joy. Nurse Joy. My bad. So yeah, this is actually the forest area that we've been to in the second dungeon, but we never actually explored the island, so we'll go ahead and do that real quick. Boy, small fry, blah, 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 I'm gonna update your sea chart, blah, blah, blah. You guys know the drill. Yeah, so this is the forest haven. Bomb merchant. Bomb Island, yeah. Yeah, we know. We'll be doing that much later. That takes a while too, so that'll probably be an episode in and of itself. The whole merchant quest line. But yeah, one thing at a time. And I remember this was the island I actually wanted to explore a few times, but every time we went here, that stupid Cyclos was around, so we couldn't actually explore it too much. Which is obnoxious, but I feel like he might be here again, just because of the way the weather's turning. Oh, you know what? This isn't that island I was thinking of. This is actually, we saw Fire Mountain at the beginning, and this is actually its counterpart, Ice Island or something. Ice Mountain, maybe? But yeah, we'll be coming to these later on. Blah, blah. Ahoy, small frog, and update your sea chart. Again, we know the drill. So yeah, as you guys can kind of see by the map, we're just doing like a little loop around the world just to find some a way of finding out the islands in a certain order. Just keeping some general... I don't know what I'm talking about. So that is Southern Fairy Island. That is where we got the bomb bag upgrade, I believe. One of them. And we also, in the last episode, took out those platforms. I guess not. I'm not sure. Because the cannons are back, which is confusing. Because I thought we took those out. And there's Outset Island over there. The island we will be heading to is right here. Stupid Cyclos. I feel like it's around this island every single time. I don't know why that is, but I feel like it always is. Looking out for that fish. Hopefully it's not by the stupid thing. Alright. Oh, that might not be close enough. Oh, I guess it was. Got lucky. I didn't L-target him that time. Alright, ahoy small fry, blah 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 blah. Shut up. Shark Island. Sweet. Yeah, and he's actually gonna tell us about the giant tornado that's right behind us. We know, dude. He's actually gaining on us, so we're gonna head out. One thing I want to keep an eye out for too is more of those big octos. And again, you can see those by a pack of seagulls all flying in a circle. The next one we will be heading to is right here. Not right there. Gosh, damn it. We might be able to do something on this one. Oh, no, we can't. Darn it. Those, I haven't talked about them, but those ships that have cannons on them, what they do is if you take out, usually they come in threes, if you take out all three of them, each one of them will drop 50 rupees or something. I don't really. It's kind of difficult. I think it's kind of a waste of time too. So. He's telling us about another item that we'll get later on. So. We're actually coming close to discovering all the islands within the middle, which is nice. Here's our third one. Or not third, I don't know why I said third. Here's our next one. So let's make sure the bait we do. This should be good. Reef. Yeah, and there's like six of these islands that are all pretty similar. They are all like bunkers of sorts, and so what you can do with those is a lot of treasure charts will end up being like the loot of those treasure charts will be inside of those things. So we won't be doing that quite yet. That'll be in the second set of collection videos we'll do, but that'll be later on. And that's actually, if you guys remembered where, what was it called? Beatles Special Shop. Oh, no, that's not this island. That is, I know that's around here somewhere. Alright. This is Tingle's Island. This is, Tingle is the guy who, I said in a previous part, I was not a big fan of. We rescued him from the jail on Windfall Island. He's, one of the more annoying characters ever introduced in Zelda. But, yeah, so we'll be dealing with this, this later on. Yeah, and he does require a lot of money later on, so we'll have to save it for that as well. But that's not for a long time. Getting all dark again. Can we just have like a nice night where it doesn't rain? Can't have everything. We're actually almost out of bait again. That's pretty crazy to me. Oh, that might not be close enough. Oh, it is. Okay, cool. Oh, it's small, right? Yeah, blah, blah, blah. C chart, blah. Northern Triangle Island. So, We'll stop here and drop off Pearl really quick. And that's, he's actually giving us the quest that activates Miss Joy and like the killer bees and all that, so fun little throwback thing. Make sure we stay on this side of the island. So I'm not sure how wide that whole thing is before we get sucked into it, so. Oh, this stupid bush. God, I hate these bushes. Ridiculous. Alright, so this will be Din's Pearl. Alright, and so one pearl remains. Must have just happened. So that's Windfall. We'll be heading to this one over here. Oh, it's another fairy island. Cool. Not sure if we've explored this one yet. Oh, this might have been the one that we went inside but couldn't explore yet. Where we got the 99 bombs. That's what I'm thinking it is. Yeah, it's definitely what it is. So after we discover this island, I'll place the third pearl in its correct spot, and then I'll end the video there. Sweet, sweet. Thank you guys for putting up with me through these videos. I know that they weren't as exciting as I would have liked them to have been, but I digress. There's not much we can really do about that, because it's just busy work, honestly. So yeah, that's Eastern Fairy Island. We've already explored it. He's telling us about the fast sail, which we already have, of course. And we'll head back south again to uncover the last available island. If you guys notice this, oh shoot, this whole area is completely empty, this whole quadrant. There's not anything we can really do yet, but in time we will be able to uncover what is hidden. So again, this is Eastern Triangle Island. We've already explored it. Oh man, it's these guys again. I wonder if they... Are these the same guys? Yo! You collected treasure, blah, blah, blah. You might give us something, I'm not sure. Bye. Okay, yeah. I guess it's the same people. Oh my gosh. My bad, guys. We'll sail away first and then set sail. There we go. I love the way that the, I know it's kind of dumb, but I love the way that the water, like, flows up and down the land. I think that's a really cool feature. I don't know if it did it as much in the GameCube version, but the way that they remastered this is just incredible. So here's Feror's Pearl in its correct spot, and this will actually activate something, so... This tower, which Pearls the gods have caused to appear, is a place that the gods of the ancient world prepared so that they might test the courage of men. Only one who is able to overcome the trials that await here will be acknowledged by the heroes, or by the gods, to be a true hero. Only then will that hero be permitted to wield the power to destroy the great evil. Link, that which you must obtain now lies before you. You must believe in your own courage, which has led you to triumph over the many hardships you have faced. And you must triumph once again. You must rise above the trial of the gods. So yeah, guys, this is where I'll end the part, but this is the Temple of the Gods. We won't be exploring it this episode, rather in a few episodes from now, as we still have a little bit of collecting to do, but we're actually making our way towards the end of that little run. So thank you for putting up with me for the last few episodes. Hope you have a great rest of your day, and peace.